history. Most of you think, what is talking about history? That's one of the boring subjects we have to read, because there is lots of characters, lots of war, lots of empire, lots of kingdoms to remember, and we couldn't find any interest there. But I'm telling you, history is one of the most interesting subjects you can figure it out. I'll suggest take it as a web series, because when you start a web series, you didn't know how many characters are there, where they came from, what's their job. But after complete the web series, you remember all those things for so many long time with interest, and you need that interest in history so you can remember all those things for so many long time. Today I'm telling you about medieval India. Medieval period is one of the important period of history of India because of the development in the field of art, language, culture and the religion. Also the period has witnessed the impact of other religion on the Indian culture. Beginning of the medieval period is marked by the rise of Rajput clan. This period is also referred to as post-classical era. The medieval India lasted from the 8th to 18th century. With early medieval period from the 8th to 13th century and the late medieval period from 13th to 18th century. Early medieval period witnesses wars among the regional kingdoms from North and South India, whereas late medieval period shows the number of Muslim invasion by Mughals, Afghan and Turkish. By the end of the 15th century, European traders started doing trades around the mid-18th century. They become a political force in India. Now we see main empire's events in medieval periods. Rajput Kingdom. Rajput came from the first time in the 7th century AD, but historians give different theories of their origin. The Turkish invasion, 1000 AD to 12006 AD. North India during this period was raided by Muhammad Ghazni. He sacked Sonaut Temple many a times. Prithviraj Chauhan defeated Ghori in the first battle of Tarain, but he defeated by Ghori in the second battle. With this comes rules of Sultan of Delhi, Delhi Sultanate. The Khiljis, 12009 AD to 13020 AD. Delhi Sultanate was taken over by Jalaluddin Khilji, but he was murdered by Alauddin Khilji. Then he took over his position. Khilji ruled most of the South India. The Tughlaqs, 1320 AD to 1412 AD. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq brought Tughlaqs into power. Famous Tughlaqs are Muhammad bin Tughlaq and Firoz Shah Tughlaq. The Sayyids and Lodi Sultans, 1414 AD to 1526 AD. Sayyids ruled Delhi from short duration and take over the Lodis, who moved the capital from Delhi to Agra. Many small kingdoms emerged with the decreasing power of Lodis. Following those two dynasties were powerful Vijayanagar Empire and Brahmani Kingdom. Chola Empire, one of the most prominent empires in South India that ruled from the Tamil Nadu and extend till Southeast Asian nations. The Chola, unlike most of the other rulers, were not from outside but from South India, who contributed a lot towards political, architectural, cultural spheres of India. Cholas had strong army and powerful navy. During this period, Buddhism and Jainism flourished to a great extent. Along with these fine arts, metal casting and literature touched a new heights. The Mughal Empire, 1526 AD to 1857 AD. The Sultan of Delhi were replaced by the Mughals, who had great patronage of art, music, culture and architecture. They ruled strongly till 1707, and after this, Mughal Empire weakened and distinguished. Jahiruddin Muhammad Babur founded the Mughal Empire by defeating Ibrahim Lodi at Panipat in 1526 AD. The word Mughal has its origin in Babur's Mongol ancestry. Babur recorded all his experience in Tujuki Baburi. In 1530, Babur's son Humayun came into power. A battle at Kannauj in 1540 brought Shershah into power. But again Humayun returned Delhi and Agra. He re-established Mughal rule in India. He was succeeded by his son Akbar. He was the great empire and brought almost entire India under his rule. Jahangir, Shahjahan and Aurangzeb are the other Mughal kings, the great Marathas, 1674 AD to 1819 AD. Hindavi Saraj was established by the great Maratha Sibaji and then he became a Chhatrapati. So those are the empires ruled over medieval period, and Bhakti movement also happened during this period. So if you like the channel, please press the bell icon, like, share and comment. Thank you.